Hello, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I teleported over here back to the Gerudo village area, town, whatever you want to call it. Pretty much to just get away from the Iga environment after, defeating Koga when we were over there. We're just going to switch back to the clothing for the stuff that we have to do here. So I need to go and talk to what's her face, since we got the AM back that she wanted. Wait, how's a Goron in here? Hello? Why did we let him in? Well, that's strange. I have to find her. Did I run right past her? Is she upstairs? Is that the issue here? I'm guessing she is upstairs, for there would be no other place for her to be.
Well, you certainly got here fast. I should have expected as much from the princess's own appointed knight. She was out on a survey all day today. Still as the sands now. So, spill it, boy. Have the two of you been getting along all right? It's okay, I know. Your silence speaks volumes. She gets frustrated every time she looks up and sees you carrying that sword on your back. It makes her feel like a failure when it comes to her own destiny. Don't worry, it's not like you carry blame in any of this. It's unfortunate. She's put in more than enough time. Ever since she was a young girl, she's gone through rigorous daily routines to show her dedication. She once passed out in the freezing waters trying to access this sealing power. And she has nothing to show for it. That's the motivation driving her research. I'd be doing the same thing. She really is quite special. You be sure to protect her with your life. It's quite the honor. The night brings a chill. It's probably time we take her in. Or...
Urbosa! What was that? Did you feel that? Wait, what? How did you... What are you doing here? What's so funny?
Okay, so we need to meet up with her. We will find her in a minute. There's a sand seal plush toy on her bed. Strange. I don't think we can read any of this or like any sort of tablets in here. There's no rewards or anything just for coming in here. Can't even break that. There must be stuff around here in general. I wonder if you can go up this waterfall with I doubt it. And I doubt anybody will catch me if I wear it. Oh, never mind. So they kick me out immediately. Well, we can go back. It's just I have to be wearing this.
Sabak.
I've already spoken to them about that before, I believe. I want one of the rented ones because they go slightly faster than the other ones. We'll buy one for 20 rupees. Head over there now. It's not that far away by the look of it. These do go pretty fast. It's right here. Oh, do I? I thought I was wearing like stuff I was basically causing a problem for a second, like, because it was wearing the sword. Nothing here. I was like, can I grab this from there? But thankfully I can. So if the state in this little protection bubble with her to not get zapped by lightning when we get close to the camel. She moves at such an awkward speed. Just stay fast. Go with me. No. I have to like stay with her. It's too cloudy to really know my way around here though. There's also a shrine nearby. It's so weird, I thought it would have made her grow at full pace like all the time. What is this? She just... She gimmicked me, in a sense. She got stuck behind a pillar and I couldn't get to her because she went the opposite way. Wow. I'm trying not to, you're just being, like, a weird distance. Okay. Here we go. Duplett's bow is badly damaged, apparently. I need to re-equip a bunch of stuff here. I need the bow. Wait, because mine broke. And I also need the master sword and the night shield still equipped. I also probably need to heal because if I get hit again, I'm probably gonna die. I need something. Just meat in general. There has to be just normal food kicking around in here. There we go. Any electrical resistant stuff here? What? Got like destroyed by the camel, crushing me there. But Mipha revived me.
Unfortunately, I cannot appease Naboris on my own. I have no choice but to entrust the rest to you. Don't let us down, Link. sure do know how to keep a woman waiting. I can't wait to see you take Noboris back from Ganon. One thing at a time. You'll need a map to find your way around. Head over to that guidance stone over there. Sounds easy, right?
Okay, she gotta destroy all of these. In a way, my night spell isn't that strong. I thought it would be way stronger than this. Alright, we're gonna change our equipment and stuff, assuming that we're not gonna roast to death in here. We are going to switch over to the Hyween gear. Our temperature doesn't seem to be increasing dramatically, which is a good thing. So we should be alright, I think, for now. The Master Sword is also at 60 permanently in this like area because it's a dungeon. Because of the Ganon infestation, it is permanently at 60. We can use it pretty much freely. I don't think it will depreciate very quickly. That is not something I need to hit. That, however, looks weird. Will probably be magnetic in some regard. Huh. I think I understand what to do with it. Now from there, maybe not. Huh. Perhaps not, never mind. I lost the chest in the process of doing that. I thought maybe I understood what to do, I just couldn't do it. Well, I guess. I had a neat idea. That's all I'm gonna say to try to get that. It seemed like it was a thing. Anyway, that's not the area I need to go to. That's another guardian. Another broken guardian. The main area I have to get to is where exactly? Up here, right?
Good work getting the map of the Divine Beast. The terminals that control Noboris are noted by a series of glowing points on your map. Take Noboris back by activating all of the terminals. You're ready for this.
Okay, let's look around here and try and get all the terminals. This one back here was, well, goodbye chest, I guess. We're gonna have to move some stuff here. I don't really know how this works quite yet. The whole room turns. Which is quite interesting. So, if I rotate this again by 90 this way, this cylinder moves. Right, so this dungeon is probably just a little bit confusing at first, just because of the mechanics and the way that the camel seems to work. It seems a little bit more confusing than the elephant or the bird. This also seems to be a bombable surface. Magnetic chest that I could have probably got from over there. I don't see anything else around here. Pull myself up to here. And then where now? I have no idea. Gonna have to turn it, I guess, probably, to make this, like, up the right way. I can't even understand what to do now. Get rid of that for a start. Durability up. Well, oh, never mind. I had enough space for it. I thought I didn't at first. There's no way up there at a minute. I need this cylinder to turn more to the right, the back one from where I am. So this one here. I think, anyway. Whoops, in some regard, like, I wanted to explore this area, but I'm gonna have to go over here. Clearly a guardian on the bat side, judging by the health mirror. There's more malice here, but I don't see the eye. This is my first time, taking on the camel, so I don't know where everything is. That's why I'm just kind of exploring. The bomb arrows. Okie doke. I don't know where to go from here. I do have Revali scale, but I don't want to abuse it too heavily. Just because I assume some people won't have Revali scale here. But I do have it, so I can use it pretty freely whenever I want. Turn it this way again. So I can get to the connecting areas by walking around here, but I don't think anything out here really connected me properly to the right part that I wanted to go to. This, however, needs to be turned. This cage needs to be turned a total of, what, like, twice or so? So I have to go back again, but I just wanted the concept to understand what I had to do here. Okay, it's back to the way I thought it would be. Now, if I turn it again. And go to here, then turn it whilst I'm inside of it. To get to the terminal.
There are four terminals remaining. I'm counting on you.
Then turn it again. Can't get out of this side, can I? Doesn't seem so. so back into the middle part here. I'm gonna turn the middle. Oh, great. May have a slight problem. Okay. From here, I have to get up there. I just don't really know how quite yet. I'm facing the back, and that has to go this way. From here, how do I get up? Around this side, around the back, I guess, like I did before. This side has to be turned. Don't see the chest that was there before, so I'm gonna turn it again. I want up onto this bar so I can make it to anywhere, but like, it's being a little bit problematic because I couldn't see. I'm not sure how I would get up here without Revali scale. I'd imagine you have to make a little puzzle from one side of this room to the next, just to navigate it properly. I'm just judging by the way that the room is structured so far, but that is what it wants you to do. But Revali scale seems to be an easy solutional answer to this dungeon for the most part. Let's see. Is there anything that works with this? Okay. Okay. Don't understand how all this works so far, but I'm just moving it along just in case it magically does something. It does not. Find out what that does in a minute. Electrical current, I guess, of some form. Can I climb this? Yes, I can. It's a ladder. A malleused door, but I probably can't get through either. So whatever this is, isn't really the answer right this second, is it? Turn the middle again. There's that chest, but again, I need to find a way over to it. Well, gonna have to actually find a way up now. I think I kinda understand what it wants me to do, it's just, it's a little bit problematic to actually do it. It wants me to, when this turns, to walk around onto this side, I think. But not as early as I just did. Cancel it because I want to figure this out without using Revali's skill. Why is the front turning? I haven't even been through here yet, I don't think. Just a night shield. Yeah, it's just a night shield. Let's see. I don't really need it. That's the issue with it. Common is dirt at this point, there's really no point in me even going for it. Alright, I need to turn this onto this side, I think. Open it from here. Ancient shaft. I've been up there also though. How did I get up? For front pain probably moves. My back is here. So I can probably navigate it somehow. Yeah, I was to navigate up to there, and then from there figure it out to climb higher. Alright, I'm gonna rotate the middle part again. Did it once more. Get up onto the higher part right here. As you can see, we can kind of probably navigate up there just a little bit. The back pain can move up like that, though. So I need to make it to go up there. I kind of understand now. That's the power strip beam that has to go to the front from there. Okay. Jeez. This thing is my connecting part that I wanted to get onto. I've already been in this part though, so now I need to figure out how I'm gonna keep the power, like, straight, more or less. The power beamed to this thing. So, this has to turn. Plates back in the middle. Okay, so far that didn't work. No way to go higher either from where I am. Power LEDs are on the bottom right now. Probably need them to be on the top. Maybe the power will come from here? Okay. So these all conduct electricity. Okay, that one doesn't seem to work so far. I need the higher up one, right? Okay. Then this one here goes further along, probably. Or do they all need to touch? Like, I guess we all need to touch. Even though this shouldn't be required, right? Oh, I see. I can move them a set distance away. Or not. Now I'm just really confused. Wait. Oh, I see. There we go. Eventually. Now I have to go up. If I can get up. To here. Onto the top somehow. Not really sure how it wants me to do this. Since, like, the goop is above me, like, properly above me, so I'm not really sure how it wants me to get up there in the first place. Oh, that chest was meant to go up the top when the neck rose. I understood. Well, I understand now. I don't understand what the heck I'm meant to do with this, though. I guess I'm meant to lower the thing. Is it actually turning, or what is it doing? Yeah, okay. So this should war again. Or not. How do I... What? The war its neck again.
Mipha's grace is ready.
I just don't really see a way past it. The front is open now. So this moves. I'm guessing if I stay in it, it will go to the top. Right. Then this thing gets turned with magnesis. Or just pushing it, I suppose, also works. Okay. I push it the opposite way. Oh, no, no, I can't. It doesn't like that. Turns me over wheel. Okay. So I think I'm meant to get on this. And this takes me up some many areas higher. A terminal.
There are two.
Two left, just have to find how to get there. Goop everywhere around here. I just don't see any eyes. I also don't have a valley to get up there just to see what is there. Like, he's not available to me at this moment in time. Still don't understand how to get higher from here. Made it back to the top at least. The terminals are all above me. Smell like that created a hole in the roof to get into the next section anyway. I've already been through here and it was just the eye. The eye was the problem. But I think... the eye was the issue, but I can't get for here. This room doesn't change in front of me. That, however, does. The neck has to come up from where I am. I have to stand here whilst my neck goes back into place. Thank you.
Rivali's Gale is now ready.
The fact that it was on the timer is annoying. Terminal for here? Probably. The Guardian. Great, he shot me as well. What about going higher? Is there anything up here? A chest. Another chest. Ancient screw. I don't know what's beneath me. Nothing too extravagant so far. Seems to be down here. Guardians and a few other things. I did it. I can go in here though. Both of them are broken now. I think there's another one? He's on the lift though. Well, he's on the elevator. So I don't really care for him right this second. I could totally cheese this one, though. There's no giant orb ball thing to go with there right now. I could jump that fence with Farfalle, I'm pretty sure. But I'll try and figure it out the normal way. There's a terminal right behind me.
Just one terminal remains.
Just need to get on the lift, I guess. Since I'm probably going higher. Unless it stops here. In which case it's kind of lame. It does. The orbs that are above me. How do I make this go higher? I don't think it goes any higher than where it is. That's the issue. No, it does. Dang. Now I have to wait. One higher. I kind of wish you could control it yourself, like, with how slow it is. You can probably just drop this in from here. More malice, but I don't see the eye anywhere. If there even is an eye for this one. Just gonna cross over. Oh, there's a ladder to get here, okay. I'm guessing the thing comes up here. No? No. Just that power needs to be on to make this move. Connect them both together. I'm pretty sure I dropped it above me, so I'm gonna have to go get it. Just a chest. I dropped it from here, or right here, right here. I need one of them to power that. Now, I don't know if another one even exists. There it is, right there, jeez. Got it eventually.
Well done. That was the last of the terminals. Now, you'll need to start up the main control unit. Take a good look at your map. Head for the glowing mark you see there. You're doing well, but overconfidence can be a deadly foe.
So let's heal up before we go into this boss battle. I need food in general. Where can we possibly get some? We'll just get some from Vitz. And attack up probably would be a good idea. 9 minutes of attack increase. I probably don't need 9 minutes. I probably only need like 3. And I'll put it on when we get there. But I have to equip the Master Sword anyway. We're gonna use it against them since it's like glowing, resonating, it's gonna destroy, you know, Ganon, whatever else. So let's go and find a way in again. I feel like that should let us get back in again, but apparently not. This has to let me in at some point, right? Yeah. Now the main part has to be the right setup.
on your edge, Link. This formidable adversary was made by Ganon, and brought me to a warrior's demise 100 years ago. Do not allow this to be your end. Fight for your life, and its death.
Okay, so we're gonna equip Revali's bow, and we're gonna fight with what we have so far, and I'm also gonna take the attack up food, which I had over here somewhere. 3 minutes 50 is probably all I need for mighty meat. And bomb arrows. It's fast, like she said. Wow, okay. I need to get up there and get my bow back. I was hoping you would let me jump, but apparently not. I need the bow. It's not letting me get up, is it?
Link.
Come on, dude. I want my weapon back. Is it so much to ask? There, I got it back. Now I actually need to heal, because I took a crap ton of damage trying to get my freaking bow back. That'll do. Alright, I sent it down eventually. Pin me up against the wall there. I tried to backflip, I just clicked the analog stick into crouch again. There. Second phase. Magnesis. I think I understand what I have to do. I just have to be in the right position to make it work. Why won't it lift? I don't even know where it is. Where is Thunderblight? This room makes it very difficult to be able to tell where it is half the time. There it is. Great. Okay, I got it eventually. He went down here. That was really strong. It died eventually. Terrible fight, but it died eventually.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Link. Thanks to your valor and skill, my soul is free. And Noboros is ours once again. Which means that finally, we can complete what we started years ago. We Gerudo have no tolerance for unfinished business. I've waited so long for the moment to see you finally rush Hyrule Castle. As well as for the moment when I incinerate Ganon into a pile of ash. Which reminds me, I wanted to give you a little something. Please accept this gift, which has come to be known as Urbosa's Fury. It will no doubt be of use to you. Both you and the princess, I know you have suffered much regarding what happened to us champions. But this is how things had to happen. No one need carry blame. So please, make it clear so she understands that. Tell her to shed any worries. And let her know, I couldn't be more proud of her. You take good care of the princess. Oh. And also, take good care of Hyrule. Legend of the Gerudo, celebrated over ages. And you, who were named to honor her. You are a legend as well. Isn't that right, Noboros? The bitter essence of defeat from a century ago still sits upon my tongue. But that is now in the past. It was written that Calamity Ganon once adopted the form of a Gerudo. And that will make this victory all the more satisfying. I like that. Now I can take this personally. Once we've established a lock on that thing, it will be up to Link to keep Ganon occupied until the moment we unleash our strike. That moment is going to be so delicious. You
So, we have a Borsten Sphere now, and yeah, we still can't get in the city here. But this guy is still running around. So we can probably trick him. So we have a new side quest to get his sand boots. This guy is weird and creepy though. But we can go talk to Urbosa and clear the final part of the Divine Beast quest also. Urbosa, I forget her name. The little girl who's in charge of all the Gerudos. Or Gerudos. I call it Gerudos, personally. I know some people call it Gerudo. Daybreaker, my inventory is filled though, but I'm gonna get rid of something. Since they're so common now, and this scimitar. Drop this one. So, I have to resolve all the people's problems also. So I need to find everybody's quarrels and resolve them. But I'll probably do that next time. Since at the moment I feel like I'm done for now. So thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time in Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.